And now, ma'am, if you don't mind, I'd like to back up a bit to the basic and, as we say, the headline things that people are trying to grasp. Before I get to the allegations being raised in Congress, ang isang lumalabas na headline na nagugulang tanga mga tao, if the word bankrupt was brought out, people are saying nawawala na ng pera ng PhilHealth. Let's start with a basic understanding of that. Kumusta po ba ang health? And is there such a scenario where PhilHealth can actually quote-unquote go bankrupt?
When we started this year, we had 130 billion in reserves. I have to explain this. No? The way we work is that every year we collect contributions and then we use those contributions for payment of our benefits. No? Yung hindi namin nagagamit, sineset aside namin yon into a reserve fund. However, we are limited only to have a reserve fund of around 2 years of expenditures. So we have a reserve fund. So we don't touch that reserve fund. Lumaki na lumaki yan, up to 130 billion na tayo at the end of 2019, because every year we pay our benefits through our collections. See? Mm. But now, kakaiba tayo ngayon because of this pandemic. So aside from the contributions from our employed sector, we also get contributions, premium subsidy from national government for the indirect contributors. Meaning these are people who has no capability to pay, therefore national government pays for their premiums. So dalawa yung sources namin, the actual collection of employed sector or the direct contributors and national government premium subsidy. So subsidy for the payment for premiums ito, no? Payment for premiums. We compute the number of indirect members and bill national government for the premiums of these indirect members. So dalawa yon. So and we have also a reserve fund and we have earnings from our investments. See?
So now,
what happened in the pandemic? In this pandemic, our contributions for the direct contributors bumaba, no? Although yung so bumaba yon, understandably because of economic reasons, hindi makabayad yung mga tao, nawala ng trabaho, maraming tao nawala ng trabaho, hindi sila nakabayad. So doon sa employed sector, bumaba ang contributions namin. Ngayon, doon naman sa national government, I said we compute, no, the number that's supposed to be paid for us because these are premiums. We requested for around 136 billion, pero ang ibibigay lang sa amin ay 71 billion. So it's inadequate to pay for the premiums of the indirect contributors. Because of this situation, and because of the pandemic, meron tayong sinusunod kasi na model dito, all of these current assumptions can eat up our reserve funds and the projection of our actuary is maybe half of it, mauubot, or not naman half. She said around 50 to 60 billion, makakain yung reserves namin this year. So next year, if the situation will continue, mauubos ang reserve funds. Ang reserve funds. See, those are assumptions based on what's happening now. But we hope that if the pandemic recedes and the economy improves, then mag-iiba na itong assumptions na ito because more will be paying, contributing their premiums. And we have been in contact with the Department of Finance and DBM on that issue for the indirect contributors. They know about this. We have been meeting with them. And they will not allow that to happen. So what they're saying is they might give additional fund on that. They might give additional fund on top of the 71 billion that they promised us. See? So it's inadequate. 71 billion is not adequate. They have to pay, give us more for the premiums of the indirect. So if they do that, then as fresh funds coming in, then our assumptions and the projections will change. See, so that was an actuarial projection with what is happening now. But national government said they will not allow that to happen. They will add more funds into the system, the program.
Yes.
Because talaga naman dapat, because they're paying less than what they're supposed to pay us. So yun, that's what happened. That's the projections of our actuary.